Hi friends, welcome back. I hope all of you are safe wherever you are and you are maintaining the social distancing. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make easy way of making dhoka. For that, I have used 200 grams of ready-made dhoka mix. To that, I have added 1 cup of water, which is hot, not boiling water, but it's hot, and about 50 grams of baby shrimp. Mix that well and let the mix absorb the water. I'm not using boiling water because it would cook the shrimp before. When the water has been absorbed in a in a pan, heat about 2 tablespoons of oil, any oil, and add the mixture and continuously stir until the mixture thickens. When the mixture has thickened, put it in a dish or a tray and press it to give shape. Then cut the mixture into desired shape as you want. You can even roll it into balls and deep fry it. For the masala, I have used 2 tablespoons of oil, a whole garam masala in which I have used cinnamon and cardamom. To that, 1 tablespoon of jeera, 1 medium sized potato chopped, and 1 medium sized onion finely sliced. Toss everything in the pan until the potatoes are half cooked or 70% cooked and the onions have browned a little bit. What are you guys doing in your free time, and how are you spending the quarantine? I know it's very hard and a lot of people are suffering, but I hope this passes soon. When the potatoes are about 70% cooked, add green chilies. I've used 4 green chilies because I like it a little spicy, but you can obviously moderate up to your taste. Add salt. Sugar. If you don't want to use sugar, you can leave this, but I feel like you need sugar to have a balanced taste. Keep the pan in medium to low heat, don't turn the heat high. To that, add about a quarter teaspoon of haldi or turmeric and half teaspoon of coriander powder and any vegetable mix you can find, like alu masala or chole or any sabji masala. Mix that well together until the rawness of the spices are popcorn. Then finally add about 1/4 cup of yogurt or dahi and mix it in low heat. If you turn the heat high, the curd will split or separate, which you don't want. So always keep the heat low while adding curd. Finally add about 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala and mix it well until the oil starts to separate. To prevent the curd from separating, you can also add a little bit of corn flour or besan, which is gram flour. Then add the pre-fried dhoka and mix it well. Now add about 1 cup of boiling water or from the kettle and let it cook for, we'll cover and let it cook for 5 minutes. This is totally up to your preference. If you want, you can cook the gravy further if you want a dry preparation, or if you want a thick like a runny preparation, you can add more water. I don't know. I hope you liked today's video, and if you liked it, please subscribe and like the video and follow me on my social media. Bye, I'll see you next time.